How are you guys? Welcome back to my channel. And in today's video, as you can see, I'm going to be sharing some tips about organization. So these are some organization ideas and tips, and please ignore my left eye. I had a bad experience with eyelash extensions, and that could be kind of like a story type of video for another time. If you want to see it, just let me know in the comments. These ideas that I'm going to be sharing are some things that I have been doing and that you might find helpful. That way, when you get home, your space is all organized and it's ready for each time that you will have someone come over, whether it's a family member or a friend, and it always looks nice. So without talking anymore, let's begin. Okay, so tip number one is to begin with light colors for your space. So in my case, I don't get a lot of natural light, and so the way that I made it work is that I made everything look white. That way it gives the illusion that it's bigger and it looks welcoming when you come in. So basically, light colors will reflect one wall to the other and it will bounce the light, making it appear much bigger than it is. Tip number two is to begin with the big furniture first. So just think about where you're going to put everything and always begin with the biggest first. So for example, if you're in the living room, the essential furniture there is the couch, or in the bedroom, it would be the bed or a big dresser, whatever it is. But just begin with the big pieces first, and that way you can see what extra space you have left over for the smaller things. Okay, tip number three, as simple as it may sound, but it's to have an assigned area for everything. That way, when you're putting away your stuff, you know where everything belongs. Sometimes we have things and we don't know where to put them, and that's because we don't have an area for that specific item. So just try to have an area for every little thing. For example, if you have coins, they go in one place, your pencils, they go in another place, and so on. So just have a specific area for everything. That way, when you are organizing, you know right away where you're going to put it away. Tip number four is to roll up your clothes when you put them away. So instead of stacking one piece on top of each other, roll it up, and that way you can see everything that you have. When you stack one piece on top of each other, you start forgetting what you have all the way on the bottom, and then you just start using whatever you have on top. But when you roll them, you get to see everything that you have, and it's so much easier. When you're ready, you get to see right away what you need, you get it, and all the other pieces will stay in place. And this is what I like doing with my tops and my pants. I even organize my pants by color, making it so much easier to put outfits together. Tip number five is to create a stack for a donation, or a space for a donation. So every time that you don't like something or that you just want to get rid of, you know that you have that space specifically for a donation. And that way, when you accumulate a few things, you know that it's time to go donate it or sell it, whatever it is that you need to do to get rid of it. And that way you create space for the new things that you will use. Tip number six is to buy furniture with storage space. This is really important, especially if you live in a small space. That's my case. What we did, we went to IKEA, and the bed that I have came with four drawers, two on the left and two on the right, and that gives me plenty of space to put away clothes. I also did it with another furniture piece, and I get to store more items. And at the same time, I can just close it and we can sit on top. So it's double use. So not only it looks nice, but at the same time, we get extra space to organize. Tip number seven, and this was kind of difficult for me. As you can see, I have a floating shelf behind me, and basically this wall was empty, and I was having a difficult time picking between a big frame that I really like from IKEA or the shelf. And so I decided for the shelf because it gives me extra space to put decor items or picture frames. And this is something that you can use either for books, candles, and other things that you might have for organization. Tip number eight is to use small containers to organize the small things. What I like to do when I get a gift or something new that I buy, I don't throw away the container. And what I like to put away in them are small pieces like jewelry, like rings, bracelets, whatever I have, or even makeup. That way, when you need something, it's easier to grab and not everything gets cluttered. So this is something that I really love doing. Tip number 9 is a scarf organizer. I have a hanger specifically for scarves, but if you don't have one, then you can just use a regular hanger. And I got this tip from my boyfriend. He didn't have one of these hangers that I have, and so he just used any regular hanger and he folded his scarf using that. And so that way you can put a few on a hanger and it's so much easier to find one or get one when you need it. And tip number 10 is to use a paper organizer for your makeup palettes. I love putting my makeup palettes this way, where all of them look standing instead of just one on top of each other, so that when I need one, it's easy to grab and then put it back again. And this is something that you can find at any office store like Home Depot, Staples, and it looks cute and organized. So those are some of my organizing tips. What did you guys think? I hope these tips are helpful, and if you have other video ideas, then let me know in the comments and I will try to make it for you guys. Thank you so much for watching as always, and I'll see you in the next video. Kisses. Bye.